Namaste, you are welcome here. Now I am going to write one C program to demonstrate how to use printf and scanf in C programming. So let me do, I will copy this first so I can save your time, and I will press Ctrl N for new and Ctrl V for paste. And this is first program, so I will remove this. And I will just try to make it more clear. So I will remove this, and these all are not needed actually. I will remove all these comment lines so you will get more clarity about the program. So those lines are not required actually. I hope you are getting this. Thanks. Now this is the very basic building block for each and every C program. Now I am going to just read three variable and going to print those three variables. So what are the variable I am going to read? One integer I am going to read. So I declare variable a, any variable you can declare, and this is semicolon means break the line. So I told you for every statement you must end with this semicolon. So even I can write here for, I am going to next for float. So this is B. So this way you can also write, or else you can write in the same, this way. So I am writing this way because this screen is short. So I want to all the program in the same screen so you can better understand. And other is char C. So three type of data I am going to read. Okay. Now I am going to print f. I am going to just print. Printf is used to print anything on the console. The console is after compilation that shown black console. So that is like command line. So that is console. So here is, I am going to print something on console. So I am just want to print this message on console that enter and integer. Enter and integer value. So integer means, I hope you know very well, this is decimal number. So this is, and this I am just adding for bit. So within this two I am writing anything inside. Okay, I hope you are getting. So this way I can write. And to read integer I have to use scanf. Scanf means you have to use when you want to read anything from your keyboard. So this is the scanf I am using. And in scanf you have to write like this and comma, and there is a variable you have to write, and here you have to end with semicolon. So here a specifier I have to write. So what is a specifier of integer? So the specifier of integer is percentage D or percentage I. So you can write any of these things. So I am writing percentage T. Please you do make note, these are small letter. So you please care about small letter and capital letter. And for reading I have to just write M percent like this symbol and variable name. So variable integer variable type is A. So A. This way I am reading A value. So if I run this program this time, what it is going to show me? It will show me on console enter and integer value, and when I will give the value from my keyboard it will take, but it will not display. So let me write one printf to display the value which I read. So here, and I will write the value which, anything you can write as I told in the very first program. And for more clarity, more decoration, I am adding this. And again you have to write a specifier. So for integer I am going to print a, so a is integer type, so a specifier I am using percentage d, and again comma, and I am going to write here the variable, which is variable a, and again I am going to end with semicolon. So this format from where I am using from this format actually. This format, second format I had told in first program, that format I am using. So this is very fast. And if you are using other compiler, I am going to show you what you have to write. You have to write CLR, SCR and this. So this will for clear the screen. Clear the screen means that black console is coming on that. If you are writing, printing any other things, then this will clear and print the all below line on that console. Here I need not to, C++ don't need this, so I will comment this, so it will not work. Okay, and at last in other compiler you have to write get CHE. So for what you have to write this? You have to write this to print your result, to display your result on the console, means that console, that black color console. But in Dev C++ it is not required. In other program, if you don't write this in other compiler, then you have to press Alt+F5 to see the result. But here Dev C++ is very modified one, user friendly, so you need not to write. So this is the command line. So I am going to run this one scan up and print of statement having program, and then after I will go for this float reading and printing, character reading and printing. So okay, first let me control S, and this is my program 2. Any name you can give, program 2, and extension is .c, it must be .c only. Okay. So it is safe. Now I am going to compile it. You can press directly F9 or you can go and press here. Okay. So you can see here error is 0, warning is 0. So my program is called. If your error is 1, 2 like that, then your programming has some mistake. You have not some wrong indentation, not indentation, a specifier or syntaxes you have done. So please you go and cross verify if you encounter any error. Okay, I hope you are getting. If you don't get, then please you ask in comment section. Now I am going to run this program. So you can see here it is asking me to enter an integer values. Okay, what I was telling. And now I am going to read value like 585. And when I press enter, then it is going to display the value what it stored at A. Here I am writing the value is A, so A value it will print. So you can see here the value what value? A value it is printing. So A value how much I have given? 585. So it is printing 585. So I hope this first you are understanding very well. And this is console I was talking about. So when there is CLR, SCR is not available for other compiler, then it will just print. If you print other program, just start from the below, it will remain same. But when you use CLR, SCR, then it will clean the entire console and start from the very first line. Okay. The other things I was talking about, get CHE. So this is this function has the work to show this screen. After like I am just entering this and pressing enter, then it is showing like this. But if in case other compiler and I am not using this, then it will just go vanish, it will not show anything. And to see this console, I had to press Alt+F5, then only it would show like this. But in Dev C++ already it is existing facility. Without using this, we can just use this. That's why I am suggesting this compiler to you. So I hope you are getting. Now let me go and do. So this comment section actually I am going to put here, and at all this is comment, so it will not execute. But I want to keep it, because if you want to use other any other compiler, then you can use it. Okay. So now I am going to read those two, what float and character. So I want to, why I need to read times and times? I can read those two value in single scanner. Then how to read? This is more advanced. So please you try to understand. So how I am writing? you can see and you can compare with my first printer. So I am just going to write one message, like I can write anything. So I am going to write enter what I want to first read, float. So enter any float value. Float value is decimal, like 10.25, 10 point, with point any value that is decimal, float in the computer. So enter any float and this is char means character, A, B, C, D, those are char. So I am going to write char. So this is message, so will be shown on console when I will execute. So I will came to know I have to give this computer one float and character, then only this program execution will proceed. How it execute? First it execute this line, then it execute this line and waiting for the scanner. When you enter this value, then it's execute it, assign it, and again go for execution of it. Again print this, and again if I write a scan up here, then you again wait for. So this way it scans. So I am going for a scan up, and here what are the value I want to read, what type, the float type. So float, I hope you know, for float what you use, F. So F specifier I am using, and for character C specifier. So I am using that. For character, we can also use get, puts, gets, puts. So those things we will talk to later. And this. So how many I am going to read? In a scanf, always use this ampersand when scanning. This is address actually. Later you come to know. Just in a scanf, you have to use this ampersand with variable. So which variable? B variable. And other is C variable. C. And end with semicolon. So this is the format. There, how many specifier is here? 1, 2, and here is variable is 2. So this way, this is a scan of work. So here I am my reading up to one float number and other is character is done. So now I have to print the value. So how can I print? So I will write print f. And just I am going to write and slash n means break the line, means it will break the line and show. Like I am printing enter an integer value. If I use here slash n, then it will print and the cursor, this blinking cursor will come here down. So here this is just break, it goes for a starting from next line. You just understand this. So I am going to write here the float value. The float value is, so the float value is again a specifier is f. I am using a small f, okay. And again I want to break and print character in next line, so I use like this backslash n. Again it will break the line, and I will again write the character is, and for character I have to use percentage c, a small c, so c. So now I have how many specifier? 1 and 2 specifier. So I have to give how many variable here? 2 variable. What are the first specifier? First specifier is float. So float variable is b. So I will give b here. Please don't give ampersand like this, because in printf we never use ampersand. In normal case, in a special case we use when we print address and something. So that is vast concept, later we will discuss. So B and C. So this is the next version of the printf you can use. And this is the next version of scanf you can use. So this is simple version I am giving, this is the advanced version. You can write any number of specifier here, and but you must have the equal number of here variable to store the values. And in printf also you can use the same strategy. So again I am going to save this program. As you modify anything in your program, please press Ctrl S. So it will not show here anything, any star. Now you can see if I press here, now it's showing a star, means my program is not saved. If I press Ctrl S, then the star is removed. So this way you can check my program is saved. Now I am going to compile it again. You can press directly F9. So here error is 0, warning is 0. Let me execute it. So when I execute, first it will ask for integer, I will give integer, it will print integer. After it, it again go for asking for this two value. So when I give this two value, then again it will go and just ask for this, and not ask for this, it will print this value by breaking the line where it encountered slash a. So this is asking. So you can see here exactly it is asking for inter and integer value. So I am giving this is integer value, and now it is printing the value, and you can see here this is on the same line. So I have to break. So later I will show you how to break that. Let me first read. So enter any float. Float I am giving float number like this. Okay, and there float and char. So character I am going to write s. So when I press, it will go and just print. You can see here the float value is 50, 32, and 40. Why this 40? I am giving just 32. You don't get confused. Float is always extended with 6 by default. 6 value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it always come with 6. So that's why it is showing like this. So you need not to worry about this. And here the C is not working actually. So let me check what is the mistake. So first let me break this line. So how to break it? How to break? So I will just here backslash n, so it will break the line. Regard C, let me check here. Okay, here you maintain when a specifier you write, you maintain the space. I hope now it will work. So here for break I use this, and if I want to double break the line, I will write 2. You can simply understand it. So this is, and save again. I will go compile again. First, after any modification you compile, then only you run. Okay, so this integer value I am given. Now you can see here, earlier it was here, now it is one line break, and this is second line break, so it is on the third line. So this is again float number and asking. So I am giving float number, and I can either write here a space, and I can just type the character, or I can enter and type the character in next line. Okay, any uppercase, lowercase, like capital letter, small letter, you can type. So you can see here the value is 6540, and this is the character is R. Okay, am I clear? So if you have doubt, please do ask in comment section. Let me modify it. Can I print this value down? So let me show you. Of course we can, because this variable already declared, and where the value is storing, we just need to go there and print. So I will cut this line, and I am going to print this entire value at the last. So the value, the integer value, let me write integer value. The integer value is, for more decoration I am writing. So what I can remove here from this is not required. You can even write this program like this way. Okay, am I clear? And this way you can break for your clarity sake. You can do like this. So first I am printing this, and this any order I can print. You can write this. So this is the problem. I'll save this again, and I will again compile it and run it, and then I am going to give the integer value. Now it is asking for the float value, and it is character, any character, so e I am giving. So you can see that here is gapping. So if I want to maintain, then I need not to break the line, then I can again go back and just remove this, so it will not break the line. So this is simple things. You just play with, play like anything, so you will learn the code. This and this value I am giving, like 6 value I am giving, so it will print this 6 value, because by default it takes. And this is any, like y I am giving any. So you can see here now how nicely it is. So you can decorate, you can play with, and you can learn. So thank you very much for watching this, and in case of any doubt, please do ask in comment section. I will definitely reply you. Thank you very much for watching.